to pick out that solo by Jim, but I'm sure the message applies to so many of you. Failure isn't final with the Father. You can start all over again serving God. Recently, I've talked to you about Tim Sturby's new CD, 18 Beautiful Solos that will be a blessing in your home, in your automobile, and as you share the message of Christ's love with your neighbors. Please, if you haven't received it, please ask for Tim's CD when you write this week. Also, I've talked to you about our reprint of this series of television talks on the parables of the Lord Jesus. Perhaps you've received a copy of that book, perhaps you have not. When you write this week, I hope you will find time to write. Your letter is tremendously important. We stay on the air because you believe in what we are doing and God is blessing what we are doing. I hope you will find time to write this week. And when you do, all the address you need is Faith to Live By, Box 426, Winnipeg, Manitoba, R3C2H6. Right now, I want you to listen to the women's trio, and this is their word for you. For you, I am praying.
And now he is watching me.
text is 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again unto a living hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. I have good news for you. An estate is being distributed. The law office handling the estate is administered by the Holy Spirit, the same one who by his power brought Jesus from the dead. Have you ever received a notice in the mail that someone, a parent perhaps, or an uncle or a good friend, has included you as a beneficiary under the terms of his or her last will and testament? The Bible tells us that Jesus died. It also tells us that out of his riches and glory, he has included you as a beneficiary of his will. Of course, a will is of no effect unless the benefactor has died. And that exactly is what happened on a lonely hill. One day, outside the city wall, a cross was raised against the sky, and on that cross was the Son of God. For 6 hours, he languished in pain, and when the soldiers came to break the legs of the others who died with him that day, they found that he was already dead. All they did was to thrust a spear into his side, releasing blood and water. He was dead, and his was an atoning death. From time to time, Faith to Live By receives bequests from dear friends who prayed for us and supported us during their lifetime. But now in death, their will states that funds should come to this program to assist us in our God-given task. Well, Jesus died. They had to borrow a tomb in which to bury him. His seamless robe was claimed by the soldiers who gambled for it. You would say that Jesus died a penniless, insolvent, but you would be wrong, dead wrong. He left a huge estate, not in terms of houses and lands, but in terms of grace and salvation and eternal blessings, eternal riches, treasures more precious than gold. Go with me, please, to the first epistle of Peter, the big fisherman. Chapter 1, verse 3 tells us why you are enriched in all things by the gospel. It says that you were chosen in Christ from before the foundation of the world, that you should be received by him. And verse 3 tells us why. According to his abundant mercy, he hath begotten us again unto a living hope. Here is something not subject to the gyrations of the Canadian stock market. Here is something beyond earthly riches. Jesus, by his death, activated a will, and you are a beneficiary of that will. Believe it, my friend. I want you to believe it. Please read carefully the details of your bequest. I read here in 1 Peter chapter 1, because he died, you were begotten, adopted into his family, that is, born again of his spirit, made an heir and a joint heir. You were a begotten. And then this is the good news. You are now a child of God, if you will accept it, that is true for you. Not only that, but our text talks about a living hope, verse 3. An inheritance, incorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you who are kept by the power of God. On a hill, Mount Calvary, the place of a skull, Jesus died. But he left a huge inheritance. You, my friend, you are mentioned in his will. He has good things for you. You are a part of his family. You are a child of God if you believe in his atonement. His estate is vast. and it is eternal, and his assets are now being distributed. That's glorious truth. Right now, you have peace with God, and that's because Jesus died. Right now, you are accepted in the Beloved. The assets of his estate are enormous. In fact, they reach far beyond this world to give you wealth untold for long after this life. And when you've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, you'll have no less days to sing his praise than when you first begun. This is a big subject and a glorious subject. The bequests that come to your benefit because Jesus died for you on the cross. I am tempted to go to every book in the Bible to try to find out something about the riches that are yours in Christ Jesus. I will resist that temptation, and I will simply tell you what Peter says about that inheritance. It is incorruptible, it is undefiled, it fades not away, and it is reserved in heaven for you who are kept by the power of God. Today, I am speaking about the wealth that comes to you because Jesus took your place on Calvary's cross. Riches that last forever. Riches that never lose their value. Riches that are not eroded away by inflation. My parents worked hard all their lifetime, and when they died, they left an estate, but it wasn't large enough to buy one house in Winnipeg at today's market value. But I'm talking about the estate that Christ has led. Your name is listed on God's list as a beneficiary of what Christ has provided when he died. And it's for all who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation. Verse 6 says that some of us are in heaviness through manifold temptations. And verse 8 adds that the people who receive the benefits of this bequest are rejoicing, even though they are beset with many temptations. Well, that's you, isn't it? You have faith in Christ, you have a living hope, but here in this world you realize that you're surrounded by temptations. I'm talking about you today, and I'm talking about the riches of the inheritance of Christ that comes to your benefit. First of all, there's a present salvation. There's a glorious and living hope. And there is joy in spite of temptations. Someday, my friend, we will receive the fullness of our inheritance, a harp, a home, a mansion fair, a victor's palm, a joy untold are mine when I get there. Salvation now. That means freedom from fear. That means fellowship with God and the assurance of eternal life. And it also means that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is, and we will rule and reign with Christ. I don't understand that. That's way beyond my imagination. But someday I'm going to realize its reality, and I'm going to sit down with Christ on his throne. The Bible tells me that. And I'm going to enjoy his presence and know his abundant and everlasting grace. He has left heaven. He who was rich became poor, that we through his poverty might be rich. In Matthew chapter 19, I am told that everyone who has forsaken father and mother and houses and lands for Christ's sake and the gospel's will receive 100-fold in this life plus everlasting life on ahead in eternity. You say, that's too good to be true. No, that's the reality. Because Jesus died, he bore your sins in his own body on the tree. Because he took your place, there's healing in the atonement. Because he died, there's eternal life for you. Jesus, the Son of God, took my place, bore my sin, paid my penalty, and now I have freedom, I have life, I have a sure and certain hope for all the ages yet to come. The benefits accruing to you, my friend, because Jesus died for you. You are on the list. You are one of the recipients. Oh, don't pass it by. Salvation now and eternal life for the future. It's all yours by believing, just by believing in Jesus.
Manitoba, R3C 2H6.